And this is Christy from Christy's Beautiful Life, and I'm here with another Spiegel Mom Scraps Minimalist Thursday. So what I'm showing you here to start off my layout is that I use my stencil and two of the shimmers dazzlers, the Redalicious and the Dreamsicle, to make this fun little pattern here. And now I'm just going through my photos, trying to decide which ones I think are going to work the best. And I had two kind of options here, but I decided that these fun photos taken back in 2014 when we went to see the pumpkin patch, but there was a little goat farm on there as well, were going to be the ones to go with. So you're gonna watch me trim down my photos. I wanted them to fit within the squares that I had made, and luckily the I didn't measure it or anything. I literally laid down the stencil one way, did it, let it dry, laid the stencil down in the opposite way, facing a different direction, and laid it down, and it happened to make a perfect 4x4 square. So I really lucked out with that. You see, originally I am trying to work with three photos here, but I couldn't make it work. I didn't like it. It just wasn't. It wasn't working, and then I cut the goat's head, and then it really looked funny. So in the end, this is going to turn into just a two photo layout and not a three, but that's okay. It was worth trying, and it was just an extra photo I had anyway, so I really didn't mind making it cutting it up and using it. And then I decided that the photo I wanted to use the most was this photo of me. It was just a better selfie of myself than the first photo. And I did again kind of chop off the goat there, but that's okay. It's more talking about being out as a family than it is that we're visiting goats. So I didn't really mind the fact that it's not really, you can't see the goat really well. So now that I've done that, you can see I'm taking away that third photo there, and I'm like, okay, what am I gonna do now? I really like the way this is looking, but I have absolutely no idea where I'm gonna put my title or journaling or anything. I no clue. So the first thing I think about doing is that it might look really neat if I bag it with some pattern paper just for a little bit more splash of color. I had, as you can see, cut my original background, that wood grain paper, just a little too much, so I had to put a little strip back on, and I came up with my title, which is pretty boring. It just says family outing. But what I was excited about is this that you can see right now, me spelling the word outing with. I have had these stickers forever, and so I was so excited to finally be able to use them up. I don't think I can spell any more words with them, so they can go away and out of my collection. So that was really happy, and I loved that. And now I'm going to just work with a few of the sequins here. I am using the Mocha Mint Dream. Again, absolutely obsessed with this sequin pack right now. I just can't stop using it. So I used just a few of the colors and a few of the triangles. I really like the way that that looks. It's subtle, but I don't know, I just really loved the way it looked. And then a few little added embellishments here. I'm adding this little heart that I found, and I liked it as a little banner. It does kind of cut off the layout a little bit, so it might not be the most pleasing look, but I'm okay with that. And I did also add just a small little bit of pattern paper down at the bottom in blue to help tie in with the fact that there's some title in blue. And now I'm doing again just some final embellishments here. I went through all of my sticker sheets off camera, and I literally went through every single one, so that's why I didn't share it with you. And I'm just deciding where I think things should go. At the bottom down there, I'm going to add the date that this happened back in 2014, a little plus sign in gold. And then to my photo with Jackson and Sean looking away from me, I added that fun little tag there. And I'm going to add a piece of floral, but just the leaves. And I originally wanted to use this piece, and I like it there, but then in the end, what's going to happen is I'm not going to keep it there because I switch it out with the other floral piece that I'm playing with. And I just like the way it looked a little bit better. So here you can see I knew I was just going to use the green. So when I put it next to me, though, it was a little too bright green next to the fact that I'm wearing blue. So I think about it, but like, no, what if I move it back down here? Because there's already green in the photo, and that I really liked. So I'm gonna leave it there. And as I'm looking through some stuff, I also found this. I think it says sightseeing, and it is from the Journey collection. And I have just a few stickers left from that collection that I've been kind of having a hard time using. So anytime I get something used up from there, I'm very excited about that. And then my final kind of added piece here is I'm adding something that says, "We were here," and you can barely see it through because it is kind of a clear sticker, but I really like the way that looked. It's just a little bit of added interest that if you're really looking close at my photo, you're going to see it. Otherwise, you'll miss it. I really like to do little things like that. I think it helps kind of bring in, like I said, added interest for people that are a little bit more into looking at all those little separate elements to people's layouts. And finally, you see, I do finally get a piece of floral onto the photo by myself. This is from the On Trend 2 collection. I play around with where I think it should go for a couple moments, but in the end, it does kind of go right back by my head there. And that I really like the way that looks as well. And so I kind of play around with where on earth I'm going to put my journaling. And to be honest with you, I still haven't written it yet. So it's going to become hidden journaling, and that's going to wrap up my layout. Thanks everyone so much for watching. Bye.